out these city lights. Let's just leave it all behind.
Welcome back to Campfire Chat with Alaska Chick. That would be me. Tonight we are going to talk about Dall sheep. Master Guide Terry Overly is going to join us tonight again, and we're going to ask him what we want to know about Dall sheep hunting here in Alaska. Okay?
Yep. See if I can tell you.
When moonlight drifts into your eyes, yeah, I just want one little kiss when we get high.
So how long have you been sheep hunting?
I've been sheep hunting a long time.
Honey child, we'd be running free and wild. No one care what you do, ain't no law to answer to.
The first sheep that I ever took for a hunter, for a client, it's been a long, long time.
How old were you when you guided your first sheep hunt for your mom and Bud?
I think I was 18.
To your eyes. I just want one little kiss when we get high on the ridge.
Now let me state this. The laws and rules with assistant guides,
yes,
were different then than they are now. And so that was okay.
Yeah. No, I'm not worried about that. We all know and understand that, you know, you're doing this when rocks were formed.
Yeah.
So, they expect that. Were there any laws and regulations when you started sheep hunting?
Now take my hand, walk with me, sun come up through them trees. Give you all I got to give, that's how we live up on the ridge. Won't you come?
How old were you when you started booking the hunts? When Pioneer Outfitters came to you, and you were Pioneer Outfitters, after your mom and stepdad died.
I can only make a wild guess. I mean,
guess for us.
I was probably 28.
So how long has that been? Holy God.
Whoa.
I do math quite quickly. All right, so you've been doing this a while.
Yeah, 27, 28. I don't really remember. I'd have to check it out. See, we've been doing it long enough that I don't remember.
Here's another question for you, and I know what your gut and initial reaction is, push by it, all right, but when a hunter that has been booked for a sheep hunt calls you up, you know, they chit-chat with you, they ask questions as they come to mind, and just basically call you because they're excited and they're looking forward to coming up. When he asks you what camp you're going to send him to, what do you tell?
Let's blow out these city lights. Let's just leave it all behind. Get up where the air is still. You can hear the whippoorwill. Start a
fire. You know, certain camps are very good for sheep. You know, our sheep camps. We can also hunt moose specifically. In any camp that we have, we can take any of the games. You know, occasional black bear, grizzly bear for sure. Sheep for sure. And doesn't mean that all of those critters
are in all of those camps all the time.
Yeah, or in all of those camps all the time.
I just want one little kiss when we get high up on the ridge.
Alright, another question for you. How many sheep hunters do you take a year?
It kind of varies. Years ago, we took quite a few more sheep than we do now, but it was a different world at that time. Regulations weren't the same as they are. The season was the same.
Here's that old boot out. Give you all I got to give. That's how we live up on the ridge. Won't you come with me tonight where moonlight drifts into your eyes? Yeah, I just want when we get high up on. let's get it for the magic's gone. Tall, tall grass all around.
Anywhere between 3 to 4 or 5 sheep hunters.
Okay, and the follow-up question is, how many sheep hunters did you take out last year?
3 last year.
How many were successful?
We had 2 successful. And the one that wasn't successful, we saw many sheep, we stocked up on a couple of rams. One's going to be a beauty this year, but it was just too close to call.
Talking about being a professional guide out in the field, that is my job. That's what I consider my job, is to be able to know, both for your client that you've trusted me with, and, you know, also for the benefit of the sheep. I want to make sure, number one, he's legal, and number two, that my client's going to be happy with him. You know, because we were talking about sheep earlier. We were looking at some of the sheep horns we have around, you know, camp here. And just getting ready and refreshing what we know about sheep, you know. And I was pointing out, I don't like broom sheep, but that's personal. I really love the classic look of the Dall sheep. So there's more to a successful hunt than just killing a trophy, right? Sadly, it seems to me, and maybe it's just learning to listen better, but it seems to me over the last few years, a lot of the clients aren't as interested in the overall hunt if they don't kill their trophy. Has it always been like that?
We've had clients like that from the beginning of time, if you will. You know, Esther's first starts, you know, being up here at 16 years old. And a lot of the hunters that would come up even then wanted to have good trip. That was the first thing. And Jack O'Connor kind of stimulated some of that, you know, writer. They had, you know, TV movies and stuff like this and started doing the things they were doing. And he liked the trips. He always wanted trips, 20-day trips, 21-day trips, longer trips. He liked being in the woods. He liked being in the outdoors and taking a big trophy. Taking the trophy was just incidental, basically, to the trip that he was taking. But life in the fast lane has kind of changed people's attitudes toward that.
Them trees give you all I got to give. That's how we live up on the ridge. Won't you come with me tonight? We're moonlight
trees. Most people are life in the fast lane. I mean, the prices of hunts have gone up. The price of gas has gone up, and the price of groceries has gone up, and just the economy.
I just want one little kiss when we get high on the ridge.
What makes a successful hunt?
I think a successful hunt would be whenever your client and your guides having a good time working together to take a trophy, to go hunting, and enjoying everything that's involved in that. I mean, because sometimes it's hard to enjoy coming back home, you know, at midnight, and when it's cold, and it's hard to enjoy climbing mountains 4 or 5 times, and looking at sheep, for example, that are just a fraction away from being legal.
Yeah, that's got to be really hard on them.
And that's just...
It's hard on us as guides.
Well, it is. But, I mean, every single band of sheep you see isn't going to be a hulking full curl, you know, 38 inches or 36
yeah.
inches. They're just not going to be.
Well, it's against the law to guarantee hunts in Alaska.
You cannot guarantee
And
success.
It's against professional ethics for guides to guarantee. I mean, it's our job to make sure the sheep are legal. Make sure that everything is taken care of, but most especially make sure that no laws are broken. That things are done right. Wouldn't you agree?
You again, give you all I got to give. That's how we live up on the ridge. Won't you come with me tonight? When moonlight...
Okay, there are some things that the guides are not in control of. You know, to see that your client has a good point. And that would be weather. We can't control the weather. We can't actually control if a legal animal is going to be present in his allotted time, be it 10 days, 12
no,
days,
no, that's true,
it is,
too. And that's a heartbreaker.
What you do ain't no law to answer to. Dance around in the dirt, listen to them crickets chirp. Hear old Jake start to howl when he hears that old hoot owl. Give you all I got to give, that's how we live up on the ridge. Won't you come with me tonight, where moonlight drips into your eyes? Yeah, I just want one little kiss when we get high up on the ridge.
There are a couple of other things that will influence your success.
Like what?
Like kind of the ability to climb the mountain.
Oh, physical fitness?
Physical fitness. And their ability to place the shot when it comes time to place the shot in a spot.
Marksmanship, yeah.
Marksmanship.
I've had my share up there, and it's just like, you miss, shoot again, you missed.
Well, they shoot again and again and again, and then it runs away.
Yeah.
Hopefully,
yeah.
You see them and say, but we don't let them do that.
No, no, they have to do it right.
And then the sheep is not to be legal.
Yeah, we keep coming back to that because that's the kicker.
One little kiss when we get high up on the ridge. I just want one little kiss when we get high up on the ridge.
How physically demanding are our hunts for a sheep hunter?
They're physically demanding. I mean, they're not that difficult. We have taken a lot of hunters, different ages, different genders, sizes, good shape and condition, and they seem to do okay with it. I think that what you need to do is just concentrate on this is what you came for, and we're going to work with you, and we're going to... I mean, some guys can just run right up the hills, and others can't, and women. And the ones, sometimes the ones that are least likely looking, do the best. You know, so it's a matter of just state of mind, I think.
Let's blow out these city lights. Let's just leave it all behind. Get up where the air is still. You can
I'll never forget the first sheep hunter you sent me. Do you remember him? He walked with the arm crutches.
Oh, yeah.
He was the guy that would slither faster than most guys could, you know, sneak. You know, because when he had to get real quiet and stealthy, he would drop his crutches, you know, lay them down. And then he'd just slither.
Yeah, I think he'd gotten a caribou or something.
Yes.
Maybe Todd or somebody.
Years before.
Yeah, and then you come back up here.
Yeah.
Then you took a moose hunt, too, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, that's when
yeah.
you lost my vest.
Yes, that's when I lost your vest. God, he's never forgotten the vest.
That was a nice vest.
It was a nice vest.
I mean, it was camo, but I really liked it. Now I got out of camo.
This is like 1995, and he holds a grudge.
Listen to them crickets chirp. Hear old Jake start to howl when he hears that old hoot owl. Give you all I got to give. That's how we live up on the ridge. Won't you come with me tonight, where moonlight drips into your eyes? Yeah, I just want one little kiss when we get high up on the ridge. Get it for the magic's gone. Tall, tall grass all around. Come on, lay that blanket down.
I've taken some pretty old dudes. She put, you know, I get the slow ones so I can feel strong. And that's okay because, you know, as long as I'm out in front, I'm feeling pretty strong. Because it isn't easy. You know, I mean, we've got some pretty hair-raising sheep hunting, and we've got walks in the park, and quite honestly, neither one are easy.
Well, they start off to be easy, and then they turn out being
they're pretty magnificent once you get there, you know? And I think it's your heart, because if I can do it, I believe anybody can, as long as that's what they want, because honestly, the way I get sheep, the way I've gotten up every mountain, every single one, is remembering two things. Number one, they told me I'd never walk again. I'd never ride a horse once they decided I might be able to walk again. And number two, one step at a time gets you there. And as long as you're not going back down the hill, you're going up. Incredible ram, and boy, we chased him all the way around that flat top, and he got him. I mean, we put a big sneak, and it was about as far out as you'd be happy with, you know. And I asked him, I says, how do you feel about it? Because we chased him, we already had aged him, and he was full curl and beautiful, but it was just, gosh, it was almost 400 yards. And he said, absolutely, I can do it. Boy, he sure did.
As I recall, he was a touch over 38 inches and good heavy pieces.
Beautiful ram for him. You know what he said to me when we were done? Boy, I'm glad I got that out of my system. I thought that was great.
Yeah. The entire adventure. I mean, you know, you killed the ram, and it got dark on you.
It was horrible. It was coming off that mountain in the dark. It was very hard. It was very frightening.
So you have to be ready for things. You don't plan to do that.
No. No. Nope. Yeah, and it was. We got down. We got a little fire built. We got down. And the first thing we did was we sat on the creek for a while and just drank. We were so thirsty. And then we stripped the horses, took their saddles off, took all their saddle blankets and pads and laid down and went to sleep. We weren't in any mood to try anything else. We got down. We had a sheet. We got down. No. That ceased being the main thing trying to come down that mountain. We got down. We were feeling pretty good about that.
But, mm-hmm. set out to go do something like that.
No. No, but you just, you know, you rely on each other. I mean, and that's what we did coming down that mountain. You know. We took it one step at a time. Because we had to, you know.
But things like that happen, and so you just have to be able to do whatever it takes to. I mean, just like getting
stay safe.
Off the mountains out
yeah.
there, you know, this
yeah.
year.
Oh, I know it.
But it was cold. End of September, and it was 0 or below 0 when we got back here.
Yep, it was really cold. Lots of snow.
Wet, wet, froze,
yeah,
cold.
Glenn's
low.
Feet got super cold. What would you say the biggest obstacle there is for a successful sheep hunt?
I think state of mind.
Let's blow out these city lights. Let's just leave it all behind. Get up where the air is still. You can hear the whippoorwill. Start a fire, pass the shine. Won't be home till morning time. Shout your name out in the wind. Confess my love for you again. Give you all I got to give. That's how we live up on the ridge. Won't you come with me tonight, where moonlight drifts into your eyes? Yeah, I just want one little kiss when we get high up on the ridge.
Even as much as we try to explain everything to prepare them, so there's no unrealistic expectations. You know, it is hard hunting, but so worth it. Just enjoy it.
Yeah, it's all an adventure. Even if it's even if you don't think it's a really good adventure at the time, once you get it done, then you look back on it.
What was it, Joey Kangaroo shared a quote he read the other day. You know, when you're on an adventure, you're wishing you were back home safe. And when you're sitting at home, nice and safe and cozy, you're wishing you were out on an adventure. He couldn't tell me. So, let's see, what else can we cover for sheep? Well, we have some sheep horns. Whoops! I forgot which set I had. Okay, we have some sheep horns here. Whoa! Alrighty, well, we have some sheep horns here. I don't need that. This is a winter kill. So, nice, whoops! Nice and dry. Alright, let's stick them back up. There's one. Okay, I hope we covered enough about sheep hunting here in Alaska, here at Pioneer Outfitters, to answer at least a few of your questions. All right? Let me know if you want to know more. Terry thinks you should see the horns I brought out here, but the camera doesn't show them. All right.
Grab them closer.
Yeah, all right. There.
See, we brought these horns out. And I was going to show you how we age them, all right? But that's kind of hard in the light you have. But This ram, how old did you say this ram was?
I think we figured he was 8.
8? Here, hold him here for me. I'll count him quick. All right, so there's his lamb tip. 1, 2, 3. You see how I'm turning it around, right? You know? So 2, 3, 4, 5. That ought to tell you just how hard it is to do in the field. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, that might be an 8th ring. That would have been under hair, though. This final ring would have been hidden by hair. So you'd be sitting there studying him, looking at him. Actually, I'd say he's probably well past full curl, so we'd have probably noticed that to begin with. And it even mentions in the regulations in a couple different spots, it cautions you about trying to age them in the field. Because it's not easy. It's not easy with the horns sitting here on your lap. And it is a lot easier when you can turn them upside down and twist them around as you're counting. A lot easier than looking through a spotting scope while he's just doing his own thing, sitting there eating and messing around and bumping heads. So, anyhow, you gotta leave me a question, give me a direction to go so we can have another chat. And if you want me to include Master Guide Terry Overly, I will. Okay? Take care. Have a great week. Bye.
Come on, girl, it's almost dawn. Let's get it before the magic's gone. Tall, tall grass all around. Come on, lay that blanket down. Wildflowers just like you lay on me like morning dew. Now take my hand, walk with me. Sun, come up through them trees. Give you all I got to give. That's how we live up on the ridge. Won't you come with me tonight? We're moonlight drifting.